And welcome to Synthetic Biology 1. This is a course about biological design. When you complete this course, you'll be prepared to design living things that are useful or beautiful, practical or fun. So what can we make with synthetic biology? Let's start with some examples to get you motivated. In Sweden, a biotech company is using bacteria to produce recombinant spider silk protein. Spider silk has amazing properties: strong, tough, lightweight, and super stretchy. But do you know how hard it is to farm spiders and to milk out the spider from their little spinnerets? It's super hard. But genetically modified bacteria can produce silk proteins in large quantities, enough for sweet spider silk jackets. In Brazil, genetically modified mosquitoes are being used to control the mosquito population without chemical pesticides. You see, only female mosquitoes feed on blood and spread disease. Using clever genetic tricks, we can breed huge numbers of male mosquitoes that are genetically sterilized. The sterile males compete with the natural males, but they produce no baby mosquitoes. Field trials are showing success in controlling dengue fever and other mosquito-borne diseases. In Switzerland, biotech researchers studied the metabolic pathways of the vanilla orchid. They took the genes responsible for the production of vanillin and expressed them in yeast. Yeast grow much faster than orchids, and their metabolism is much more active. Active enough to compete with chemically synthesized vanillin to flavor sodas and desserts around the world. This is a huge global market worth hundreds of millions of dollars. In the UK, a little girl was treated for leukemia with genetically modified T cells. These are the white blood cells that you need for a healthy immune system, but that are wiped out by chemotherapy. She got new T cells from a healthy donor, modified to keep her body from rejecting them. These treatments give patients more time to find a perfectly matched donor. In the US, the first International Genetically Engineered Machines, or iGEM, competition took place at MIT in 2005. One project, built by undergraduates from Texas, was a bacterial camera. These are bacteria that can sense light and produce pigment in response. Using the right stencil, the bacteria can spell out the message of your choice. Hello world, anyone? In California, researchers created Cynthia, the first bacterium with a completely synthetic genome. This project took 10 years and cost $40 million, but the next one will be much easier. So the technology already exists to write a complete genome in a computer, transfer that genome into a cell, and bring it to life. The next generation of scientists face the question, what should we write? So, to summarize, medicine, energy, industry, art, fashion, the environment, every part of our world is touched by living things and might be affected by synthetic biology. Some people are super excited about this. They think it's the best new thing since computers. Other people think it's very dangerous, that if we screw it up, it means a disaster that can never be fixed. But either way, this is a technology that people need to know about. That's why Synthetic Biology 1 wants to be a class for everyone. We start with a little calculus, a little basic biology, but you're smart. You can pick it up as we go. If you're a college student, an artist, a lawyer, a cheesemaker, or a rocket scientist, we have something to offer you. But we're not here to do pop science. We're gonna go deep. The whole process of synthetic biology, from aptamers to zymogens. We're gonna write the DNA sequences, we're gonna build the models, solve the equations, and hang out in the lab until the experiment is finished. So until next time, I'll see you soon. Thank you.